Recording in progress. All right. Welcome to the Q&A for site analysis. Yesterday, we just went to the site with all of our weird stuff and started working on it. So you should have a ton of data. You should have a bunch of broken augmentations that you wore on the site, notes, leaves, berries, dirt, drawings, and some photographs. And I said them in that order because I think that all of those first things are way more important than the last thing I said, which is photographs. I think the photographs serve the most use to index a valuable memory that you have, but I think that the photographs are actually probably the least valuable thing that we measured. Shout out to Azita, Azucena, and Fanta for organizing and asking for this tutorial session. We're gonna record it. We might not record all of the ones moving forward if we do more of these, but we're gonna do that for you now. And thank you to everybody who is here. Aiden, Brigitte, Jacqueline, Felicity, Aldelis, Azita, Azucena, James, Prutha, Fanta, Joey, and Audrey, and Danny, who are all here. So you guys get participation points, and that's nothing to sneeze at. So thanks for, we're a learning community. Thank you for building the learning community by being here. I'm gonna share my screen off my iPad right now to get started. So the objective here today is to show you guys that there's lots of different ways that you can do site analysis. And we are preferencing always doing something that's a little bit digital and a little bit analog, which means it's a little bit handmade and it's a little bit digital made. So if I share my screen, I have some photographs that Ivano wanted to share. And so here is, this is a drawing by a very famous architect. I'll have you guys maybe poke around and find who you think it might be. This is really interesting. So this is a design drawing. This is trace paper on top of trace paper on top of colored paper. And what I like about this is that it's both messy and precise simultaneously. You can see that the designer was thinking through drawing, sometimes with very obviously like a straight edge to get things to align very precisely, but also doodling. There is pencil, there is pen, there is colored pencil, maybe even highlighter. It definitely looks like there's a color marker. And there's all sorts of drawings happening on top of each other. This is something that's that demonstrates that he's interested in working through the idea, not making it beautiful. The beauty comes through the working out of the idea and the layering of the information on top of each other. You can see there's like a stair-like kind of component to this, but the stair keeps folding and moving. The other thing I think is really interesting about this and what makes it visually very beautiful is it's almost as if the paper keeps turning or the idea keeps turning. And so while it might be difficult to say, oh, this is the project, instead, we can see here is how the idea relates to other components of the idea. And that's really the spot where we're at with this project, right? We don't know what we're designing. We don't know why we're designing it. We're not even interested in the baggage, shall we say, of what should it or should it not be. We're interested instead in the explorations and the documentation of that exploration. So this here, where all of these things are kind of layers of trace on top of each other and the idea overlapping itself again and again and again, and different and precision and sketch-like drawings overlapping on top of each other. Now, if I was to do this, I might start to get nervous that I'm gonna mess it up after a while. And that's where digital stuff comes into play that I really like. So you start making sketches, and then what you can do is that you can take pictures of those sketches and then overlap them in Photoshop or InDesign. And that's one of my favorite things to do, is to take the sketches and then be able to move them around, because when it's on trace paper, you can't do that. So I can make individual things in my notebook, or I can take things from my sketchbook and I can do other drawings on trace paper, and then I can photograph them and I can put them together. So that's our first drawing. And that is the afternoon professors talking about doing that. And we're gonna go this way. Okay, this is another one. So this is working through an idea. This is another architect. Ivano digs the Italian architects. So we have Italian designers that we're looking at here. So this is a different type of a sketch, right? Where perhaps this person is looking at items on their breakfast table, but also using it to start to draw and sketch ideas. So there are things that are other things, right? We could say like, oh, that's definitely a fork, but perhaps that's also something in the landscape. There's things that are definitely like everyday objects, but then he's evolving those everyday objects into other things. And sometimes to just warm up and get your ideas going, it's very hard to like think really hard about the subject and just sit down and do it. So I think I like this as a warm-up exercise. Okay, I was gonna just share a couple of the photographs from the other day. So this is from my section, you know, and here's an example of, we all know that this is a picture of a pond with lots of green growy things on it. But if you're not familiar with it, do you guys see how it just kind of looks like green flat yard space? So it's not, the memory that it triggers is more valuable than the thing itself. So, and you know, here's another picture of it. And then here's the family portrait of the afternoon doing their thing. As we work our way through here, yeah, here's we go. Here's some more of that green slop. All right, the duckweed that's in there. Now, what I think would be fascinating would be if anybody got a sample of the duckweed, those little tiny green leaves, and then did a close-up picture of it, maybe used Photoshop to kind of excise them from the picture, or maybe if you actually like with your hand, or I don't know, a frog paw, scooped it out of the water, laid it on a piece of white paper, and very carefully took a picture of them so that we could get what they look like. I think that would be particularly interesting. Let's see if we can't look up what that might look like. Let's do this here. Let's say duckweed. All right. Now, these are the kind of images that I'm thinking about. And I guess we could Google them and just include them. But because I know you're all headed back to the site, because part of your homework is to go back and find what you missed, I'm less interested in this photo from foodnavigator-ua.com. I'm way more interested in the one that's legit, that is you doing this. Like, I think that would be far more fascinating. But since I don't have that photo yet, I am going to save that just for future use. I do love how they're these little tiny, it's like it's a super miniature lily pad. It's like a lily pad at 16th scale. It's far more valuable to get whatever it is that you guys created from it. Okay, and then here's all of my photographs that I have from you guys. You know, and one of the secrets of taking good pictures is actually to just take a lot of pictures. I think this really proves, we all know that this is the dark stairwell. And I think Elizabeth is proving Prutha's idea about reflection really well here, because this is a dark space, but it's lit up by that reflective piece. So there we go. It's amazing how the reflective piece in this photo just totally disappears. So like, I know what this is all about, and it was a really valuable experience, but again, the photograph just doesn't do it justice. And this is called taking a photograph when you didn't know you were taking a photograph. So again, here's another example of where the site just looks like a big green wall. So a drawing is so much more valuable. All right. So I'm going to stop sharing my screen now, if I can get back to here. And we're going to say stop sharing. Cool. And turn off the video on upside down, Andrew. There we go. Okay, now we're going to go to upside down, Andrew. And we're going to keep upside down, Andrew, upside down. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to spotlight myself for everybody. There we go. So that's scary. That's my really large upside down face in front of all of your screens. And instead, we're going to flip it down so that you guys can see. Can you guys see my sketchbook here? All right, so here's my super messy sketchbook. I keep notes in here. I doodle ideas in here. And as a matter of fact, let me just see. I think that this sketchbook is full. So you'll see that there's half done drawings. There's post-it notes in here. If you have ideas, you might connect your post-it notes in here. I have a sticker that a four-year-old friend of mine gave me. I think this is notes from your review last year. I think this is Judy's. Yep, look, this is Judy's final project. So I don't have, this is exciting. We're going to open up a brand new sketchbook today for this. I'm excited, guys. This only happens every once in a while. Brand new sketchbook with all of the sticky notes in it. So, and for this demonstration, all right, I'm going to put it here. And we're making a 24 by 36 inch drawing. And what we saw earlier was that it helps to warm up and get plans. So I have a pencil, I have a colored pencil, I have another different kind of colored pencil, I have a pen, I have this kind of pen. We got all these different types of stuff. I'm going to use all of these. We'll start with the pencil. So we know that we have something that's going to be 36 by 24. The first thing that everybody wants to do is to draw the outline of the 24 by 36, but that's not really important. What's important is the site. So earlier, you guys asked the question, like, I walked, you know, I was given an axis that I was responsible for walking. And with that fancy extension cord, you were given a swath of land that you were going to survey. So I'm just going to make a mark of that so we understand what this drawing is. So I don't know whether you guys can see that there. I might have to do it a little bit. I have to do a little bit darker. Let's see here. Nope. There we go. And there we go. All right. So we've got this area laid out. It's not pretty. I also know that at a certain point, the field stopped. And then there was water that came across it. And the water was sometimes thin and sometimes thick. There was a trail that went across maybe the site. There was rocks. Maybe there was a staircase. It got really hard to walk through, and perhaps I've run out of space and I need to add more space. I'll show you how we can do that digitally in a minute. And then there was an area that I couldn't walk in at all, and there was more area, and then I got lost over here. One of the questions was, what if I had to walk off of my site to then walk back onto my site? So you could either say, had to leave. Maybe we just write that down, had to leave. Or maybe we, you know, maybe we draw that. And then maybe we got lost. So right now we're just drawing kind of layers of stuff. This is mostly a site plan. So let's do a site section too while we're at it, where we draw and kind of draw in. There's the creek and the path, and then it kind of flattened out, and then there was a thing, and then there's a wall, and then there's more, and then it's getting, we've gone onto the other path. This is okay. So now that I've laid all those out, maybe I put a scale. So hang on, this is going to be a scale jellyfish, right? With a scale elephant trunk on it. And maybe I should go back and adjust the line weights. So let's make this a little bit darker so that you guys can see it on the recording. Okay, we could map in maybe the canopy of trees, because there was a couple of trees that were here. There was a tree that was here. So we might be able to map that in. Draw in that there was tree cover. So this was shady. This was noise coming from here. Stairs, so we might label that. Might mark some of the thresholds. So I'm going to just put some lines across where I know that there are thresholds, the trail, the creek, the grass, the shade. Maybe I'll label that down here so I don't forget. So shade, open and sun, dewy, because in the morning it was really dewy, creek, wet foot, frog, and cricket. This was dusty. This is the path. I might start saying, oh, this is the staircase. There's a traffic jam here of students. Traffic, lots of feet. I might start going back and reviewing my notes here to add more annotations. So I'm just making a plan for what I'm going to draw out right now. More shade up in here. There was like a tall tree. There was a dead craggy tree. So I might draw in that. Let's zoom out so we can start to do this. This drawing is not going to look good anytime soon. There is a campfire here. Campfire. I'm kind of writing in notes that I'll understand for later. All right, and then we might choose to start adding some more information on here. So I have my scale person, and you know what? I'm starting to lose my scale person, so I'm going to draw them in different colors so that you can see them. I remember I was able to stretch over top of the creek. Not everybody could, so I'll put myself in there like that. There was people that were climbing up here. There were people sitting over here. I'm just going to put the scale people in so I get a sense of scale. I haven't measured this. Some of you got really into measuring this. Maybe there's a way that we could start measuring how much we think there is here. That would be helpful and valuable. And maybe we want to start adding stuff. So I don't have any leaves, but this would be a really good opportunity to see if I had a leaf or a rock, if I could like add a scratch or a color or a mark. But again, this is just a plan. I'm just working on my own idea in my sketchbook, and then I'm going to make it bigger again later. Before I get too much further, remember I told you guys I get worried that I'm going to mess my project up. So here's what I'm going to do. Making sure that I have my everything flat. I have nice even light in here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hold my camera not at an angle, but keep everything nice and flat, and I'm going to take a picture of my sketch. There we go. And now I can show you, there's what my picture of my sketch looks like. And of course, every sketch needs to get post-processed. So let me show you guys what this process looks like. So here we are now looking at the picture of my sketch. So I'm going to orient it. Done. And I'm going to, before I do anything else, what I think I'm going to do is duplicate it so that I have a copy. There we go. So now I'll edit this copy. So I'm going to look at this. Let me adjust my screen so you guys can kind of see what it is that I'm seeing. I'm not going to use a filter. Sometimes I use this automatic. Sometimes. But let's crop it, because you don't want to see my hands and you don't want to see my... So we'll do freeform and we'll do the whole image like this. That gets most of it. There we go. Then we'll go into adjustments and we'll just go through here. And I'm just going to kind of mess around with it until I feel like it's looking better. So brilliance, highlights, shadows, contrast, brightness, black point. And I could even take the saturation out of it if I wanted to, but I don't. So I'm going to keep it like that for now. So we've got that too. So we've got that digitized. Now that I have that digitized, I could do some more things with it. I could take it online and work on it on my computer. Or I could do this. And so I'm going to take it onto my iPad here. I'm going to show you guys how I do analog digitally. So let's see if that photograph has come over. It might not have. There it is. What I'm going to do is we're just going to switch right now. I'm going to really quickly go and say, there we go. Infinite Andrews. Okay. Share content. Screen. Start broadcast. And then this one can go back to being upside down, Andrew, whole right side up. And we're sharing this broadcast. And I'm going to take you guys to a free piece of software I have called Concepts. And we're going to back out to the menu. And I'm going to go to new. Now, I could do this in Photoshop. I could do this in, let me actually show you an example. show you some examples. Here is a site map I made of the Delaware Valley, where I was explaining the relationship between Wilmington and Philadelphia. It's lots of different layers. Let me show you guys. Here's some studio sketches. So here is a drawing that we did for Chinatown. So that's a screen capture of a Google map that we then did a drawing across that we could then turn off, and then I could save this drawing. Cancel. Let's go to another one. Oh, maybe it would help if I rotate this. There we go. I'm particularly proud of this one. So here, let's turn off all the layers. You can see this is a pile of junk on my desk made of Legos. And then we drew over top of it to show where there were stairs. And then we added some coloring and some shading and some more lines. And if you take away the background, it starts to look like a building. So this is just layers that I'm adding to stuff. I'm just sharing this to show you guys, this is ways of working. And then let's go to here's another one with another sketch. This is actually done by, this was with the help of a student. So let's back up again. So here's a photograph. The student held their model up in front of the building that they were proposing. So they made a cardboard model. They held it in, like we actually went to the place. They held it up in front of the camera. They took this picture. Then, so they took this picture like that. We edited it out. We added some colorful things. We added some pen, and then we added some more pen. We started adding information. Now this is for a design purpose, but let's look at this if we were doing it for a sensory diagram. So here's another example. So if you check this out, again, I'm going to turn off all of this information so you can just kind of see it raw. So here's the sketch that I had from my notebook. I brought it in and I dropped it into here. Then I started to add some more color. Then I messed around with the line weights by adding more information until I felt like it was getting to be too much. And then I added another layer that was just my notes on top of it. So this was a map of my own personal space where I was next to a large window, a high window. There was a digital screen in front of me. And it's just a map. It's basically a site map, a site analysis of my desk. All right, I got one more to show you and then we'll go back to the tutorial. If I can find it, Glendenning Rock Garden site analysis. Is this it? Oh no, I got it ready. Sorry, hang on. Charswood site, athletic rec site. Oh, here we go. Sketch development of a section. Yep. Turn this. I find this very intimidating. I find an empty white sheet of paper very intimidating. So I oftentimes will take a picture of a bunch of planning or of stuff on my desk, and then I'll use that to add more information. And I always end up putting in scale people. All right, I thought I had a better picture. Studio from the spring, studio sketches, project layout. Nope. Wow, there's too many projects in here, guys. Sorry, there's just too many projects. Here, I'll just share this one with you because this one's kind of funky. Oh, here we go. Here it is. So check this out. Again, I'm going to turn off all the layers and we'll just turn them on one at a time. So here is a site analysis sketch. What you're not seeing is, there we go. That's the original stuff that we put out. And then you can see all the notes on here. So let me just draw. So there's notes here and there's notes over here. And there's even notes down here because we took a picture of it. So we had all of those different notes. And then we started drawing on top of it. And then we started drawing on top of it. And then we started drawing on top of it. And then we started drawing on top. We just kept adding things. And eventually we started taking those things away and they became interesting. So there's like views, there was a circle of noise that was here. There's a way to climb. We ended up putting all that stuff in. All right, let's go back to that example and let's continue with the tutorial, yeah? All right, so if we back up, it was in, nope, maybe. There it is, site analysis drawing. So what I can do is I believe I can say we'd like to upload a screenshot. We want to put a photograph. So I'm going to take my photograph and I'm going to size it right here. and I have it digitally. You could do this in Photoshop. Done. I could even add another photograph. So maybe I want to take that picture of duckweed and I want to put it on here. Hang on a minute. I'm going to copy it. Yeah. And then we're going to delete it. I'm going to add a new layer. And all right. This is going to be my pen layer. So again, I haven't really been worried about the 24 by 36 just yet. Let's go, we'll select the color. Let's do yellow. So here's that line that we had. That's my site section I'm responsible for. Let's do a ground plane. And we'll trace over that here. And now remember last time I ran out of space, so I could continue that now, so I can keep going. As a matter of fact, I could keep going if I wanted to. We're overlaying this. Let's do another color. We'll just do red because everybody makes water blue. Let's do it red. So we'll do it this way. Here's the creek. So now we're in plan and section. Let's do the staircase. In plan, it was here like this. Maybe in section, we'll have it show up here like this. I'll switch to a different kind of shading. Oh, different kind of shading. Hang on, come on back. There we go. Different kind of shading. Maybe I could shade in, not where the trees are, but where it was dark, right? There was a dark area. There was like a tunnel-like area that was through here. So maybe I'll make this more tunnel-like for the area that was here. And then maybe I'll write that down too. Tunnel. Maybe I should do that in type and not in. It would be really cool to start adding information here where I'm like, this was duckweed. So starting to add in those different flavors and pieces. Some of you had really interesting perceptual stuff. So maybe you have photographs. Let's just use orange, and we could say like, maybe this is a good place to put a photograph into and connect it down to this spot. Maybe there was a really interesting texture that you found. So it would be really cool to take that texture and perhaps rub it onto, or rub a, like if you had a rock and like scratch that rock onto your site drawing. Or scratch it onto a piece of paper, take a picture of that, and then drop it in with Photoshop. You could even use that as like poche for this area. What I'm not doing is making the grass green, the trees green, and the sky blue, and the water blue. What I am doing is adding notes, always adding notes. Let's go back here. We'll do not the pen. We want to do a fixed width. So, and I could add my notes in here and say it's here it's loud. Here it's quiet. Could even zoom in and say let's change that color. Very slow walking, high traffic. I was talking to somebody that's bonked their head here. Danger, head trauma. I would then take from this drawing, I can output this to Photoshop or to InDesign, and I could add text. So if you had text, or some of you were making maps of like audio noises, you could insert those here as well. So I think Judy and Hunter were making drawings that looked like noise, and they kind of looked like this. They would do a point, and then they would do noises like this. And you might link those to the areas where they happened. Where it was kind of like, this was what the noises kind of sounded like, how they were mapping it. Collecting all of that stuff together, you might start to get too much information. And what you could do is then start figuring out what do you want to turn off from your layers and start editing. the more stuff, the more questions, the more things that you come with, the more layers and options, the more layers of trace paper, the more sketches that you have on Tuesday with an organization onto a, you know, you're responsible for a 24 by 36 sheet of paper. The more of those that you have, the more your professor can help you out with those things. And then the last thing that I'm going to end on right here is in Design 3, under the announcements, besides the announcement for today, here's a narrative way about going about it. So, right, Andrew does drawings. Ivano shows examples. Ray talked extensively with folks about this. And Rachel is really strong on narrative. So she writes things. So, you know, she says, do this individually. Use your team to help. Go back into the field and collect information. Drawings are the majority of the site analysis for your transect, which is that whole cross, right? So it's a section and a plan drawing. She suggests using three variables of different adaptations. You should include a scale, a north arrow, topography. Photos should not be more than a quarter. In Ivano's section, he suggested that the border might be organized into individual drawings or pieces or like, and so see, two different professors, two different flavors are going about doing this. She is asking for the standard, which is that you submit a copy of where your digital file is at 11:59 p.m. on Monday night, making sure that we don't cross Kelly Drive so we don't hurt ourselves, and go back to the site, add more information. I think, actually, now that I've done this drawing, I have a better understanding for myself of where I would like to go back and get more information on the site. So if I went, I want to spend more time up here. And I want to spend more time up here because I don't have a lot of information. I have a ton of info from this spot. I really know very well what happens in this spot, but I'm really interested in where I put those two blue circles. And so if I'm going back to the site, I might talk to some people about it. I might partner up with a different buddy. I might ask to borrow somebody else's augmentation, but I'm definitely going to go spend some time there, certainly with my sketchbook. And the reason why I know that is because I know that photographs in this position are really difficult. So camera is tough here. So, all right. So I'm gonna leave this here for now, and I'm going to open it up to some questions to say, you know, I don't know, has me doing any of this, like, does it brought about more questions for you guys? Is there something I showed that you want me to bring back up? Do you want me to try to drop something into here? If you guys don't ask questions, I'm just going to start drawing duckweed. Start doing a trace of this drawing of duckweed, little miniature lily pads. Oh, I didn't realize that they're all different shapes. There's like a big one and there's two small ones. I did not know that about duckweed. And I could turn it off and then I have duckweed. Any questions from the silent audience? Is this helpful? I have no idea.
Yes, it was very helpful.
Thank you, Brigitte. Us professors are high maintenance. We need like constant feedback. All right, I'm going to hit stop to the